While self-driving and autonomous vehicles are still being developed, much of the technology that drives them is already here. Systems that combine automatic steering and adaptive cruise control can make driving easier, especially in stop-and-go traffic. But to be clear, these are not safety systems, and it's important for consumers to know which ones perform well and the safest way to use them. Consumer Reports looked at four of these systems: Tesla's Autopilot, Volvo's Pilot Assist, Nissan's ProPilot Assist, and Cadillac's Super Cruise. We evaluated them on our auto test track and on public highways. Testers drove the cars multiple times, both as a leading and a following vehicle, and we focused on five important aspects of each system. First, how well the system performed the primary functions of maintaining speed and steering the car in its lane. Second, whether the system was easy to use and gave the driver clear feedback on the system's status. Third, whether the systems could only be activated in safe conditions, and how effectively did they alert the drivers to not use the technology when they shouldn't. Fourth, how the system ensures the driver is still paying attention to the road and ready to take over if there is a problem. And fifth, how the technology reacts if it detects that the driver is no longer providing the appropriate feedback. So how did each system perform? Let's start at the bottom of the list. Volvo's Pilot Assist proved to be the least capable system in our testing, struggling to keep the car in the proper lane. We also found the system complicated to engage. And if Pilot Assist receives no input from the driver applying pressure to the steering wheel, it turns off the whole system completely. And that could be a real problem if the driver is incapacitated. For example, if there was a medical emergency. In response to questions from Consumer Reports, Volvo said there's little chance that a driver would become completely incapacitated, saying it's a small risk. At number three on our list is Nissan's ProPilot Assist suite. One highlight with this system is when ProPilot Assist stops receiving feedback from the driver, it does a good job of trying to keep the driver safe by tapping the brakes a number of times to get the driver's attention before bringing the car to a complete stop in its lane. Number two is Tesla's Autopilot system. It's simple to engage with a stock, and the system displays lots of information about its operation to the driver. It also excelled in keeping the car centered in its lane and maintaining its speed and distance to others on the road. However, the system works so well that it increases the driver's chances to check out and get distracted behind the wheel. An occasional pull or resting a hand on the steering wheel is all that's needed to keep autopilot functioning, but that's not a sufficient way to make sure the driver's paying attention. Number one, Cadillac's Super Cruise, for providing the best balance of capability and safeguards. It stands out for its use of cameras and sophisticated eye tracking technology to confirm the driver is looking towards the road ahead. If Super Cruise senses your eyes are off the road, it alerts the driver to look forward. We also like that Super Cruise limits where it can be turned on to only divided highways. This means it can't be used on back roads or other places where these systems are less likely to work safely. We did find that Super Cruise was a little difficult to engage, as it requires the driver to be precisely in the middle of the lane to turn on the system. But this is a minor annoyance to an otherwise excellent implementation of this technology. For its part, Cadillac says it will continue to update the system as needed. For more on self-driving technology, check out consumerreports.org.